Our Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam made lots of dua. You don't think he made dua for his uncles, his family? You don't think he considered Abu Lahab when he made dua for guidance? And if he did, despite all of that loving dua, Allah Azza wa Jalla will himself tell him, إِنَّكَ لَن لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتْ. You don't get to guide who you love. You know, there are people among us, there are children among us who wish their parents or their elders were acting in a more guided way. I've met so many young people whose parents are in a haram, explicitly haram business. And the children, the son and the daughter, is trying to tell the father and the mother, please get out of this. We're dependent on you. You're paying my college tuition. You're providing for us, but you're providing for us from haram income. And I'm not in a position to provide for the family right now, but this is wrong. And then they're told you're being disrespectful, you shouldn't talk back to your parents, etc., etc. Now, it's the flip side. It's the children making dua for the guidance of their parents. But things aren't changing. Things are where they were. These frustrating situations happen. And then on top of that are situations like health calamity. Not just family problems, but health calamity. Or you can't find a job, you have money problems. And you're making dua to Allah. You ask yourself, I even did i'tikaf last year. And I kept making dua and I didn't pick my head up from sajda all night long, and still I have this problem. Still it didn't go anywhere. So the first thing I want to remind myself and all of you is that prophets, alayhi salatu wasalam, all of them, much before us, Allah mentions their du'as consistently in the Qur'an. And Allah also mentions their problems consistently in the Qur'an. You don't think, for example, that Yaqub alayhi salam, the father of 12 sons, made du'a for all of his sons? And especially for his son Yusuf, when he lost his son Yusuf, you don't think he made du'a for Yusuf's safety, that Yusuf should come back home, that he could look at his beautiful son once again? We know that he cried so much he lost his eyesight. Ibyaddat aynahu. He lost his eyes over crying over his son. And all of those du'as for so many years go unanswered, and then they eventually get answered. You don't think that, you know, the mother of Musa alayhi salam, when she put her baby in the water, and the river just takes the basket away, the basket could flip over any time. And how do you know the basket is waterproof? How do you know it's not going to leak? How do you know it's not going to hit a rock and it's done? You know, you're throwing something in a river. It's not a joke, it's a baby in a river. You don't think that mother is making dua to Allah? And notice the difference. In that case, in the case of Musa's mother, she makes dua to Allah, and a few hours later, she's reunited with her son. Just a few hours later. By the time the baby is hungry for the next meal, he's back with his mother. And in the other case, with the case of Yusuf alayhi salam, he was separated from his father. But he wasn't reunited with his father for many years. For many, many years.